Machiavellian is Illuminati, all through your body. The blows like a 12 gauge shot. Feel me? And God said he
should. Only Gab can do it like this.
It's not personal, so I don't want to make it seem like I'm slandering these guys' names. Or if you hear about a lot of the artists, some of them used to be on Death Row, some on other labels. You might hear them getting caught with drugs, get caught with a gun, stab somebody, do those type of crimes, they're not gonna come to prison. One of the reasons they're not gonna come
like
to prison.
Snoop?
Well, Snoop would never come. I mean, Snoop was on, you know, we beat a murder trial for him, but then he was on probation, then he got caught with 2 ounces of marijuana, then he got caught with guns, and each time it's nothing. They're not gonna violate him. Because for the street guys know what I'm talking about. There's no puzzle. I mean, if you get a guy that constantly getting in trouble and never gonna come to prison, that's because he's an informant. He's a rat.
W. Balls. It's your main man, DJ. Easy Dink. About to unleash.
Oh, my nigga.
Yeah, man.
And the word is on the streets, and the word is the streets. And we're going to go to a live remote and check in with my main man, Mr. Doggy. Dog.
A day in the life of a rolling 20 crib. I'm just a stubborn type of fella with a head like a brick. And just because I sit more wet, they say that I'm hopeless. But I don't give a fuck, so blame it on the locals. Now this is how we do it when we checking the grip. Snoop Dogg is in this bitch, so don't even trip. I bust a funky composition that's as smooth as a prism. So check it while I kick off in this funky ass rhythm. It's 6 dub, the phone is ringing off the deck. And it's some homies talking about our disrespect that they said. Oh no, Dogg ain't this, y'all. I got a couple relatives above Crenshaw. This is about me and Simon, not me and y'all. I got love for a bunch of real beat-offs. Like Kate up top, Cat be real, E-Rock, Boulay face, and the homie Heron, rest in peace. Big J from Campanella Park. He used to blaze with his nephew after dark. On and on, rocking big neck bone. Mossberg, I had to put you on my song. It's so real, I had to show some love. Now back to the scrub. It ain't about Crip or blood, it's about you being jealous of what I does. Cause I does it the most. The king of the coast in the paint playing post. I back you down like Shaq Daddy and bust on you out the new caddy and skirt up Wilshire Boulevard. I'm not exhibit, you can't pull my whole car. I fucked all your groupies when you was doing time in Camp Snoopy with the fags and snitches. No killers, just bitches, and you was paying niggas off with all my riches. You so hardcore, why you ain't go to level 4? Oh, I know, but I walk the main line every time I go down. You can check my G-Files, I do it LBC style. Got the word on you, Simon. You need to just start rhyming, cause you the biggest star on your label. And them other niggas just crumbs off my table. You're not able to compete with the heat that I drop, and I still ain't been paid for 187 on the cop. I started your shit and I will end your shit if you keep talking shit on Crip. It all boils down to the fact that you're jealous how my paper stack.
Jealous ass nigga.
It all boils down to the fact that you're jealous how my paper stack. It all boils down to the fact that you're jealous how my paper stack.
Jealous ass nigga.
It all boils down to the fact that you're jealous how my paper stack. Money, get it. Paper, I got it.
I got to do it.
Heaters, I keep them. Bitches, I got them.
Run up, get done up. I stay one up.
Money, I get it. Paper, I got it.
I got to do it.
Heaters, I keep them. Bitches, I got them.
You run up, you get done up, I stay one up.
If I shoot you, I'll be brainless, and you'll be famous. And I'll be spending money out the anus. Your only gain is to try to get me to fall down to your level. Man, you worse than them devils. A lot of niggas should have said it, fuck them. But I'ma say it for them. Stop it, pop it, rewind it, and play it for them. This nigga's a bitch like his wife. Suge Knight's a bitch, and that's on my life. And I'ma let the whole world see. Cause you fucked up the industry, and that's on me. We can go head up, nigga, set it up. Or we can do the other thing, I love to wet it up. Your rappers and artists, tell them, shut it up. Cause I fuck every last one of them up, especially Corrupt. See, that's my little homeboy, so he know what's up. He better keep it crimpin' and slip his clippin', cause these niggas trippin'. This is official business. Do the same way, leave no witnesses. This is that unexpected, misdirected. Spray covered and protected. Strip your butt naked, check it, check, check it. It's all to the good again. You can catch Snoopy D-O-Double in the hood again.
time spitting that real shit to make the whole world feel it. So put the bacon in the skillet and try to peel it, cause doggy style records is the realest, nigga. It all boils down to the fact that you're jealous of my paper stack.
Jealous ass nigga.
It all boils down to the fact that you're jealous of my paper stack. It all boils down to the fact that you're jealous of my paper stack.
Jealous ass nigga.
It all boils down to the fact that you're jealous of my paper stack.
Don't get
money, get it. Paper, I got it. Peters, I keep 'em. Bitches, I got 'em. Money, I get it. Paper, I got it. Jealous ass nigga.
Yo, what up? Welcome to Machiavelli Media. I'm your host, Gab. Do y'all remember when Snoop Dogg got sick of Suge Knight's bullshit? Snoop Dogg was ready to fucking go toe-to-toe with Suge Knight. Shit was crazy, right? Because you heard the stories over the years. But it's an old saying, everything got its limits, goddammit. It's the old tale or the straw that broke the camel's back. Sometimes enough is a goddamn enough around this motherfucker. And I think Suge Knight kind of knew Snoop was at his breaking point. You know what I mean? You know, you heard the stories over the years. You heard, you know, Suge didn't treat Snoop particularly well. And in this case, you know, when Suge was incarcerated, Snoop Dogg had decided to leave Death Row. It was open season, you know. Suge was trying to use intimidation tactics and, you know, sending messages. He had the dog getting shot. That shit with the gun going off and all of that. Snoop said he had enough of that shit. Snoop Dogg said he built a blue empire while Suge was locked up. Told that nigga, bring it, on a track called Pimp Slap. Now, he said some unfavorable things about Free People, I know. You know, he sent the shot at Sharita, I believe, but he didn't say her name. So, shout outs to my homegirl, Sharita. Good people right there. When I had her in Baltimore, she came to my little boy's birthday party, man. It was awesome. You know what I mean? Got a chance to meet my wife, the kids. Wish we could have hung out more, but shit was crazy down here. I was just glad we got the show done. But, yeah, man, Snoop was riding hard against Suge. I got a question for y'all, though. Do you think the dog really wanted it? Do you really think Snoop had finally, you know, got sick and tired of Suge shit and was ready for war? Or was the dog just simply defending itself? Some say Snoop is a bullshitter. I don't know Snoop. You know, I don't know exactly what was going on between him and Tupac. I know in the Tupac community, a lot of people don't really rock with Snoop. But, you know, Snoop was saying at the time he had a kid, and like any responsible parent, his loyalty and, you know, his allegiance is to his children, you know, not to another man. And he was saying that that situation was potentially dangerous. He could have lost his fucking life. And he was saying, you know, was it worth losing his life, you know, over a Pac beef? So I guess he elected to back out the motherfucker, you know. But he got involved with his own beef with Suge Knight. Was that out of necessity? You know, because he had to? Or was he simply just tired of Suge shit? And, you know, why Suge ain't smashed Snoop like many people thought he could have? You know, did Suge lose a lot of his power that one point in time when he was, you know, incarcerated? Who knows? But I remember listening to that song, Pimp Slap, and I was like, God damn, where this shit going to go? luckily ended peacefully. By Snoop's own accounts, him and Suge made amends with each other. They let bygones be bygones. And I don't know if they're friends, but at least they can be cordial. I want to hear in the comment section. Did Snoop want smoke with Suge? Or, you know, was Snoop bullshitting? And what you think would happen? Let's have it. Thank y'all for tuning in today. Please share this video. Give me a thumbs up or a like, you know what I mean. And I'm about to hit y'all with the peace.
Machiavellian is Illuminati. All through your body. The blow's like a 12-gauge shot.